Hello, this is Carol, Kilopop 4 Mic Delta. And we're doing a demonstration of using SDR Sharp together with Visual Analyzer to set a frequency deviation of an FM transmitter. And we're going to use a 1200 Hertz tone that's put out by a PK232 terminal node controller. Of course, any terminal node controller can also be used with a any FM transmitter. The FM transmitter we're using here is a Yaesu FT-8800R, and we are feeding the signal into the data port on the rear of the radio. The SDR Sharp is set to a bandwidth of 20 kilohertz. The audio output is being fed to virtual audio cable, which then is feeding into Visual Analyzer. So we're going to go ahead and start transmitting. Transmitter's on now with no modulation whatsoever, and we're going to gradually increase the level of modulation. And if you watch carefully here on the RF spectrum, you'll see that center line, the tallest line, is the carrier frequency. Now, as we increase the level of modulation, that carrier eventually goes to a point where it's nulled out to zero. This is called the Bessel Zero, and it occurs at a modulation index of 2.4, which for a 1200 Hertz tone is equivalent to a frequency deviation of 2.88 kilohertz. You'll see now that we can look at the peak-to-peak reading on the oscilloscope here, and it's saying that about 55% of the full scale is now equivalent to 2.88 kilohertz. Now, to make an adjustment for a desired frequency deviation, now we can use that as our reference. And we'll go ahead and we'll start transmitting again. Okay, so here we are at the Bessel Zero, and the frequency deviation now is directly proportional to that peak-to-peak of the full scale that you're seeing on the oscilloscope. So what would correspond to 3.5 kilohertz deviation, which is what we're looking for with packet radio particularly, would be a peak-to-peak of 66%. And now we'll go ahead and we'll raise the level here of deviation till we hit 66% peak to peak, and that's this number right in here, 66. There we go. Now that's the 1200 hertz signal, and we'll go ahead and flip over to 2200. And here's a 2200 signal. And you see the deviation there is just a little bit higher, which is not unusual that you have a little bit of difference between the two frequencies. Here's, again, we're exact right on 33.5 kilohertz deviation here. And here we're just a hair higher. Well, let's see what happens if we continue raising the deviation. We're going to go even further beyond that. You see, we start to get some distortion in the signal. And we go up to about a maximum deviation of about 4 kilohertz there. So we'll back off again to 3.5, which would be the peak-to-peak of 66. And there we go. We'll just leave it right there. And we're right on the nose. And that's it for the demonstration. Thank you very much. Bye-bye now.